winning, Medway!
It's Friday, April 27th, and I'm Jill.
And I'm Erica, and welcome to another edition of Medway Morning. Due to a small accident in the studio, we are broadcasting live from the gym.
Any students who would like to volunteer at the Relay for Life in Lucan should get an information sheet off the bulletin board. Please complete the online registration and then give the signed consent form to Mrs. Fiddler along with the yellow information sheet found on the bulletin board.
Congratulations to all Medway Junior Badminton teams who were at TV Raw yesterday at Beale and Lucas. It was a fantastic display of school spirit. Great job, team.
A reminder to the boys' soccer team, our first game is Monday against Strathroy. The game starts at 3:30 in Strathroy, so the bus will leave Medway at 2 p.m. The team will be dismissed from period 4 at 1:45.
Now here's a message from your student council regarding upcoming elections.
Hi, I'm Elizabeth, Student Council Secretary. I'm in charge of keeping minutes for executive and council meetings, sending them out to all members, and keeping everyone informed of what Student Council is doing.
Hi, I'm Paige, and I'm the Senior Representative on Student Council. My job is to ask the opinions and express the concerns of the graduating class to Student Council.
Hi, I'm Chris, Co-President of Student Council, and my job on Student Council is to guide in a diplomatic way Student Council. I also have to be a member of each and every subcommittee that Student Council sets up, and I have to attend each and every event that Student Council puts on. In addition, I have to be the link between administration, staff, and students.
Hi, I'm Colleen, your Public Relations Officer, and my job is to relay information from Student Council to the student body with posters, announcements, MTV segments, and the updated Student Council Board.
Hi, I'm Martha, the Social Convener for this year, and the Social Convener is responsible for organizing and booking school dances.
Hi, my name is Raylin, and I'm your female co-president, and as the co-president, my job is to kind of oversee everything in Student Council and be a part of all the different subcommittees and represent our entire school.
I am talking on behalf of Emily, and she is our treasurer. Her job is to deal with all the checks and the money and hand out all of the financial statements.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is something new. Attention graduating students, your form and money are now due for caps and gown for commencement. Students with the last name starting with A through M, please bring your order to Ms. Hughes in geography. Students with last name starting with N through Z, please bring your order to Ms. Dixon in science. You cannot attend the commencement ceremony without a cap and gown.
Period 1 grade 12 classroom teachers, please return your grad write-ups for the yearbook to Ms. Timmel if you have not yet.
Looking for an easy way to get some community hours? Ms. Martin is looking for 4 senior students to help out with the blood donor clinic on Friday, May 11th. You'll be helping out in the refreshment area and will only have to work 1.5 hours to 2 hours. If you're interested, please see Mrs. Martin today.
Spirit Week, Spirit Week. It's that time of year again. Be sure to find your twin for Monday. Rock any old outfit from Blast for the Past Disco Tuesday. And Wednesday is Classic Red and White Day. Thursday is Surprise Day, and if you're after you Tide Machines are dancing, it's Friday Comfy Day. There will be free dance tickets given to the most outrageously dressed students on Monday and Tuesday, so head up to the upper calf for pictures and free tickets on those days.
Now here's some information about Medway's upcoming Neon Dance.
There's a dance, you should go!
Hello, I'm Paige, this is Colleen, and this is Elizabeth, and we are here to tell you about the dance coming up on Thursday. What's the theme of the dance, Colleen?
A night of neon!
And what time is this event running?
It's from 7 to 10 p.m.
How much can we buy tickets for?
$7 outside of the gym or outside of guidance.
And what should people wear to this event?
Wear your brightest, wackiest clothes, Medway.
There will be lots of black lights, so you will glow in all your white, bright, and neon. Can't wait to see you all there, Medway!
On December 28, 1990, the government passed a Workers' Mourning Day Act, which established an official day observed to commemorate workers injured, killed, or disabled on the job. April 28th was chosen for this observance. Although it began in Canada, the Day of Mourning is now commemorated in more than 70 countries worldwide.
Could James Lyon, Renee Singer, and Carly Moe Golinek please go to room 143 immediately following these announcements?
Attention students who took grade 11 biology last semester. There are spots available to go on the zoo field trip May 23rd. The cost is $45 and forms are available outside the office.
Did you know that someone dies of starvation every 3.6 seconds? Most of these deaths are children under 5. Today is Freedom from Hunger Day. Mercedes reports.
I'm here with Tori Bailey. What is the 30-hour famine?
30-hour famine is organized through World Vision, which is an organization that helps to raise money for countries in need.
Okay, and what goals are you wanting to achieve?
The biggest goal that we're trying to achieve by doing the 30-hour famine is just to raise awareness. That's our biggest goal, although other goals are obviously to raise enough money to help a bunch of kids that are struggling with hunger and safety and stuff like that.
Okay, thank you, Tori. I'm here with Miriam. Are you participating in the 30-hour famine?
Yep.
Why?
Because I want to help support World Vision and help them end global hunger.
Have you participated in this before?
I've done it every year of high school.
I'm here with Ben. Are you participating in the 30-hour famine?
No.
Why?
I wouldn't do very well without eating for a day or so.
All right, that sounds plausible. Back to you, MTV.
Today at lunch outside the CAF, join Youth for Social Justice celebrating freedom to be yourself. There will be tie-dye and sidewalk chalk and lots more fun.
The library computer lab will be closed today during period 3.
Calling all culinary club students. To anyone who has helped with culinary club this year or who would like to have some fun, we need lots of help. Next Wednesday, May 2nd, we will meet after school to bake goodies. Mrs. O also needs help this following week for music night.
The town of Ilderton needs your help Saturday morning to do some spring cleaning. If you would like to earn some community service hours and work for 4 hours from 9 a.m. to 1 p.m., leave a note for Mr. McGee in the guidance office.
Last night was an amazing coffee house. Thanks to Joel, Nicola, and Mrs. Douglas for organizing. And here's Miriam with how things went.
MTV, I'm here at Medway's Coffee House. At Coffee House. How do you think your performance went?
Well, I haven't performed public since grade 7, high school musical, Oxbow Public School, represent. So I think you did pretty well now that I actually have a mature voice and I'm not preteen.
Well, we all think you did an awesome job.
Thanks.
I'm here with Amy and Kira. What did you like most about Coffee House?
My favorite part was singing with Ethan.
My favorite part was definitely seeing the Mills Brothers perform. That was pretty awesome.
Yeah, they were really good.
I liked the piano man. It was really good.
I really liked Cam's happy birthday performance.
Let me just say this. On this day, my friends, music is spelled H-E-N-R-Y.
A large group of Medway track and field athletes braved the cold weather yesterday at Strathroy Track and Field Meet. Everyone who attended, including the coaches, should be congratulated for surviving the day. This year's team is strong and talented. Stay tuned for more impressive results as we prepare and for the competitive season in May. The throwers will gather tonight for an optional practice.
Congratulations to Colleen Filson on winning the Twitter Cheer Contest. Colleen wrote a comedic summary of A Midsummer Night's Dream from the perspective of Robin Puck. Way to go, Colleen. You can pick up your prize in the English department.
Well, that's all we have for today, Medway.
Thanks for tuning in for a long segment of Medway Morning.
Stay classy, Cowboys! We're down in an airplane, flying, getting sunburned.